In this example, we are going to examine the game pieces in a Scrabble game. So this figure to the right is describing what the different numbers represent. So for example, for the letter A, the small one next to the A tells you that an A is worth 1 point. The 9 to the right of the tile is telling you that there are 9 tiles with the letter A on them in a Scrabble game. So you can see that that information is given for all the different letters, the point value, as well as how many of that tile is included in the game. So that's the background information that you need to be able to answer these questions. And notice they're asking here, if one tile is drawn from the 100 Scrabble tiles, we're going to find some probabilities. So if you were going to add all of the quantities together, you would get 100. But they did that part for you. So there's 100 tiles total. We want to find the probability of selecting a letter worth 3 points. So you need to find which letters are worth 3 points, and then also how many of each you have of those letters. So if we're looking at letters worth 3 points, the B, C, M, and P are all worth 3 points, indicated by that small 3 next to the letter. So B, C, M, and P. But we also need to know how many of each of those letters there are. Notice each of those letters has a 2 next to it. That means there are 2 B tiles, 2 C tiles, 2 M tiles, and 2 P tiles. So even though there's 4 letters worth 3 points, there are 2 of each tile for a total of 8. So when you're looking at all of the tiles, there are 8 total tiles that are worth 3 points. So that probability would be 8 out of 100. Which then we can reduce by dividing by 4, and that probability reduces to 2 out of 25. When we move to Part B is going to be slightly different. It says find the probability of selecting a letter before F, or a letter worth 3 points. Note that these are not mutually exclusive events. Meaning I look at the letter B and it is before F and it is worth 3 points. So those events can happen at the same time. So in that scenario, if I'm trying to find the probability of a letter before F or worth 3 points, I have to take the probability of getting a letter before F plus the probability of getting a letter worth 3 points. But if I stop there, then I'm counting certain tiles twice. So then I need to subtract away the probability of both occurring at the same time. Letter before F and worth 3 points. So let's look at each of these. If we look at our letters before F, that is this first column here. A, B, C, D, and E. We're not focusing on the point value right now. We're focusing on what is before the letter F. So if we add all of these together, the quantities, 9 plus 2 plus 2 plus 4 plus 12, that total is 29. So there's 29 tiles with letters from A, B, C, D, and E. So the probability of getting a letter before F is 29, because there's 29 of them, out of 100. The probability of getting a letter worth 3 points, we actually did in part A. I'm going to do the non-reduced fraction to keep a common denominator. There were 8 tiles worth 3 points out of 100. Now I need to find the letters that are before F and worth 3 points. So take a moment and think about what letters you think those are going to be before F and worth 3 points. The B would satisfy that, as well as the C. Those are letters that are before F and also worth 3 points. So there are 4 of those tiles, the 2 plus 2. So I'm doing the subtraction here on the right, minus 4 out of 100. Those are left. You don't want to reduce those because you want that common denominator. So you can reduce at the end. So now if you combine the 29 plus 8 minus the 4, you get a probability of 33 out of 100. So just remember, if the events are not mutually exclusive, then you have to add the probabilities together and then subtract the probability of both the events occurring at the same time.